64-63, Robert Morris defeats Delaware State. And Charlie, before we talk about anything else that happened in this basketball game, let's talk about that last possession where Ozzie Mamadou came through with a big rebound and scored her 10th point to get the win for your team.
The ball wasn't falling for us today. You know, we had a good flow there. We started to hit some shots. We were bothering him a little bit with some actions we were doing, and then the ball stopped going in for us. We got real cold. We saw something there, we'd get a good look. Esther got a real good look. When you're missing shots, I told him, I said, get in there, Ozzy. You've been rebounding so well for us. Get in there on that shot. Do not watch. Do not be a spectator. She crashed in hard, and she used her ability to have great hands and read the ball off the rim, and she got a great rebound and put back. Then we needed to have a great stop down there. He did a great job. I mean, he came right after us there. He had confidence they would come in and attack us. We had to get down the floor, match up, and contest the three right there. I did it, not just the basket, but how we responded to get back and to contest a long shot. You know, that was a great last possession there.
Talk about the second-to-last defensive possession where you forced the shot clock violation. That was just as important as scoring the basket on the other end.
Absolutely. I mean, we needed to give ourselves a chance there. And great tracing by Bella. Got a nice tip on the ball. She does that well. That's something that she's got to continue to bring for the team. And we force a heave at half court. And then obviously executing the play at the end, get the look, and then crashing in to get the rebound. It all kind of came together at the end like there. And, you know, as ugly things were in the fourth quarter and some of the third, how we didn't shoot the ball so well, it's great to finish the game.
Talk about shot selection. That has to be a little bit of a concern in the latter stages of the third and into the fourth quarter.
We passed up on good looks to dribble in and take bad looks. You know, we've got to find our mid-range game. You know, we got it like Esther having that shot there at the end. That's a good mid-range shot. We were touching their paint the whole second half, and we just kept flying into the basket. We've got to be able to pull up there. We got to be able to shoot that pull-up jump shot. I mean, the mid-range game is so lost these days. It's a three or a layup, and they got to get that out of their head and go back to fundamental basketball. If you could take a good 10-15 footer, you got to have body control in there, and that's where we passed up open looks to drive into the teeth, and we just kept charging. I mean, they took them. I give them a lot of credit. That team was tough. They went in there, stood in the lane, took a lot of charges. You know, that was something that we saw on video. We got to do a better job of that.
You talk about the mid-range game, and that was something that was very strong for Pollard, number 22, for Delaware State. She killed you guys
today. I told her after the game, I said, you know, you could take this team really far with your mentality. She's such a cool cat out there. Like, she gets that ball, and she's just so cool with the ball. She's very under control. She's got a nice mid-range shot. She can post you up. She can step out. She's a nice player. And I told her, I said, you keep working hard for this team. You're going to take them far. We need to do a better job. On that last possession you were talking about where we the two possessions to the end of the game, we did a nice job on her there. We stayed home with her a little bit more. Dej was getting a little loose on her, stayed home with her. It disrupted a lot what they were doing. We weren't running into the paint there. Dej did a good job of talking in on her. We did a real good job with the screen up top, and that allowed us not to allow her to have the ball. That allowed us to keep the ball out of her hands. So good job defensively on that last possession that you were talking about, and we did the job on her at the end.
Nadej Polivios didn't shine brightly offensively. However, she cleaned the glass today.
No, she went after it. You know, when you're having that day where things are bottled up shooting-wise and she started second-guessing herself, you know, as the game progressed and then she started shooting it again, you know, she bottled herself up. And I told her, I said, when you miss shots, I'm not going to pull you back. You keep looking. You keep getting the look. You keep shooting. You don't just pass up on a good look when you're open. And she had a little bottling up in her head right there, but then she continued to do the other things, taking some charges, getting in there, rebounding the ball, giving us second chances. She set that mentality up, and Ozzy, you know, finished it off.
What do you attribute the growth of Ozzy over the last several weeks towards?
We've been working hard with her. You know, Ozzy was a project coming in here. She has a ton of ability. She has great hands. She's a good kid. She just needs to continue to work hard on a daily basis. And if she continues to do that and fixes some of her fundamental problems, she can be a really nice player for us. It was great to see her today because NECA didn't have a good day at all. And she stepped up and played those bulk minutes down the stretch for us. And I kept looking at it and saying, you know what, is Ozzy getting tired? And she kept working through the end of the game. And that's something that we've been really working on as well, is making sure she continues to work even when she gets tired. And that's how she did today, and we've just been working on it. She's been someone that is a project for us, and it was great to see her have a moment today because we've been drilling her on some things, and what a way to go on the break for her.
You've got some time off now, and then you've got James Madison at the end of the year.
Well, we're going to enjoy this one, and we're going to enjoy the holiday. I'll be clipping things. Our assistants will be clipping things, and we have to stay in shape on the break. You know, we have to make sure we stay fit. So when we come back, it's going to be a tall order. James Madison is a very good program. They're a top 50 RPI team every year, and they have a lot of pump there. So not going to worry about them now. We're going to get to the video, but we know we have a tough challenge coming in right off the break, and we're at home, and we got to make sure that we do a great job of getting ready. Every game, we got to get ready the same way. And so when we get back, we'll be ready to go.
Congratulations on the win. Enjoy the break. Merry Christmas. We'll talk to you just before the new year.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Again, Robert Morris with the 64-63 win over Delaware State. We're going to talk to you again on Sunday, December 30th, as the Colonials take on James Madison. Tip-off is scheduled for noon, and we'll have the coverage just before then. For my broadcast partner, Justin Piles, I'm Adam Guskey. We'll talk to you then. Have a Merry Christmas.